Okay. So, hello friends. So, today we are going to see the part 2 of yield line theory. So, in the part 1 we have discussed about the yield line theory, what is actually yield line theory, introductory part we have seen, as well as we have seen the assumptions, what is required, what is assumptions made for yield line theory design and analysis, characteristic features also we have seen, as well as we have seen the patterns of yield lines for different shape of slabs. Okay, so this basically this yield line theory is used to design the slab. So today we are going to continue with this part 2, and in this part we are going to see the derivation for the yield line theory of different slabs with different shapes. Okay, so problem statement 1 is, so in the first problem statement 1, I have taken an isotropically reinforced and simply supported slab subjected to uniformly distributed load over its entire surface. Okay, so here you can see this is a square slab, isotropically reinforced and simply supported square slab with simply supported on all four sides, divided into four segments, segment number 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay, so here you can see the deflection diagram. So this is the deflection of yield line. This is the deflection of yield line, as well as this is the deflection of yield line you can see here. Okay, and this is the reflection of overall slab. This is the reflection of overall slab you can see here. So delta is the deflection here you can see. Okay, so and length of the square slab is L. So length of the yield line is under root 2L. Under root 2L. Okay, under root 2L, total length. So here to find out the deflection, so maximum deflection is at the center, you can, we know always, because it is simply supported slab, so maximum deflection is at the center. So this is this delta deflection, maximum deflection here, having an angle of theta n, or you can say even theta also. Okay, so this, by this 2 theta here, this angle created is 2 theta. So let's see what is actually, so by solving this equation we'll get the maximum moment carrying capacity of this slab, as well as maximum load carrying capacity of this slab. Okay, we can calculate the movement as well as load, collapse load we can say, or ultimate load we can say. So in this, what actually we have to do is, we have to equate the internal work done and external work done. So we can find out by equating two, internal and external work done, we'll get the solution. So what is mean by internal work done? Means the work done due to the movement. And external work done is nothing but work done due to the load. Okay. So length of the yield line is under root 2L. So here you can see in the sketch, the length under root 2, and so the length of the yield line. So if delta is the virtual displacement at the middle, the total rotation of diagonal segment is equal to 2 theta. So here you can see, if a delta is the virtual displacement, at the center or at the middle portion, the total rotation of this segment will be 2 theta n, or you can even write down 2 theta n. Okay, so therefore just solving the trigonometric, so theta n is equals to 2 theta, we will solve the trigonometry using sine theta cos theta and tan theta, using sine of sine is equals to opposite upon hypotenuse, cos is equals to opposite upon adjacent. Okay, by using the trigonometry we'll solve this. So 2 theta is equals to delta upon under root 2L divided by 2. So solving, we'll get 2 root 2 delta divided by L. Further we'll continue. Here yield line movement across AC. So in the image you can see, so this is A and C. So yield line movement across AC, the movement is across AC is equals to mu is the movement under root 2L. So under root 2L is the span. So mu under root 2L is the yield line movement across AC. So therefore virtual work done by movement about yield line as or is mu into under root 2L into 2 theta. Okay, So we know what is the value of 2 theta. So we have already seen what is 2 theta is equals to 2 under root 2 delta by L. So putting the value in this equation, we'll get is equals to 4 mu delta. So similarly, work done by movement about yield line BD is also equals to 4 mu delta. So summation, equating this 2, because 4 segments are there, for all 4 segments equating this will get 8 mu delta. So therefore total internal work done is equals to 8 mu delta, that is deflection. So this is about internal work done. So similarly, we'll see what is external work done due to the load. So there are 4 triangular elements each carrying a load of WU, that is WU L square into 1/4. So why? Because 1/4 is equals to, so per segment we have multiplied that is equals to 1/4. Okay. So WU is the load, L is the span or length of that square slab, L square, and 1/4 means 4 segments are there. In each triangular element, center of gravity moves down by distance of h/3. So after this 4 each segments, triangle is formed. So for this triangle, CG is acting at h/3, height of h/3, that is 1/3 of delta. So delta is the depth. That is, we have got the deflection. So we'll get the center of gravity up on h/3 distance. That is 1/3 of delta. Therefore, external work done by load on each triangular element is equals to this load into this length. So WU into 1/3 of delta. So since there are 4 such elements, we have to multiply this by 4. So 4 into 1/4 of WU L square into 1/3 of delta. So we will get WU L square into delta by 3. So just continuing. Equating, so this is what we have got external work done. This is what we have gotten external work done here. Okay. So equating this internal work done and external work done, we'll get, so 8 mu delta is the internal work done, is equals to WU L square into delta by 3 is the external work done. So equating this internal and external work done, we'll get mu is equals to WU L square by 24. Okay. So that is the movement, actual movement we can calculate for the slab. For the slab, square slab simply supported on all 4 sides, So remember, this is an isotropical slab. Isotropical slab means so yield lines are not perpendicular to the reinforcement. So it is inclined to the reinforcement. Okay. So next is second problem statement. Okay. So this is the second problem statement. So isotropically reinforced fixed support square slab subjected to uniformly distributed load over its entire surface. So what is the difference in the number one problem statement and number two is, so this is a square slab, same square slab, but what happens here is the supports are different. So here in this you can observe 2 yield lines. So this is the positive yield line created due to positive movement, and this is the dotted line, that is negative yield line created due to negative movement. Okay. So deriving this equation, we'll get mu is equals to WU L square divided by 48. That is WU is equals to 48 mu upon L square. So instead of solving all this equation, I have directly written the solution for this problem statement 2, and further I have written directly the statements, because you can solve it. It is very much easy for deriving that problem statements. Okay, so it is depends upon the for boundary conditions. Okay, depending upon the boundary conditions. So remember that please remember for every different shape of and different boundary conditions, the movement will change and the load will change. Load carrying capacity will be changed. So this is for square slab fixed support on all over side and some UDL uniformly distributed load on entire surface. So third we'll see. So in third problem statement, it is equilateral triangular isotropic reinforced simply supported slab subjected to uniformly distributed load over its entire surface. So here you can see that It is a triangular equilateral triangle and simply supported on all three sides. So this is the yield line. You can see the developed yield line here. So deriving this, we'll get WU is equals to 72 mu upon L square. That is, moment is equals to, ultimate moment is equals to WU L square divided by 72. Okay. So right. Please note down this value. Please note down this value, because if in the examination they can ask the problems like this. So you can add, by using this equations, you can find out the moments or load. Okay. And for that moment, you can provide the reinforcement. So for triangular equilateral triangle, the reinforcement is provided like this. Okay. So next, fourth one is, so fourth problem statement is, isotropically reinforced a triangular slab simply supported along two edges and free along third side. Okay, so this is isotropically reinforced a triangular slab, and here you can see the two edges are simply supported and this third side is free support. Third side is free. So deriving this, we'll get WU is equals to 6 mu upon alpha L square into 1 divided by sine beta by 2 into sine beta by 2, which is equals to 6 mu upon alpha L square sine square beta by 2. So this is for load carrying. So this is for load, ultimate load, to find out the ultimate load, to find out the movement what we are using. So you can directly use WU L square divided by 24 or WU L square divided by 6 sine square 30. So this is for isotropically reinforced a triangular slab, which is simply supported on two sides and free at one side. So next problem statement, fifth is, so orthotropically reinforced a simply supported rectangle slab subjected to uniformly distributed load over the entire surface. So what is the problem statement here? The slab is rectangle, orthotropically reinforced a simply supported slab it is, and shape is rectangle, and all four sides are simply supported. So you can see the yield lines. So already we have seen in the previous video. So what will be the patterns of yield lines? So for 2A slab, it is, the yield lines are developed here. So this segment is again divided into 1, 2, 3 and 4. Okay. So here the deflection along the longer span will be like this, and deflection along the shorter span will be like this. So delta for longer shorter span is this, and delta for longer span is this. Okay. So solving this or deriving this, we'll get mu is equals to WU alpha square into L square divided by 24 into bracket multiplied by into bracket under root 3 plus alpha square minus alpha bracket complete square. Okay, so this is the equation we have to use to find out the movement for this case, orthotropically reinforced a simply supported rectangular slab subjected to uniformly distributed load. So this equations we have to use. So next case is, so problem statement, polygonal slab isotropically reinforced is subjected to uniformly distributed load over entire surface with fixed edge. Okay. So what actually is here is, so it is a polygon having fixed edge all over the periphery. So you can see the length of this span. L is the span and R is the radius, you can say. This R is the radius. So here, so movement can be calculated by using mu is equals to WU R squared by 6, and the load can be calculated by using 6 mu upon R squared. So these are the two equations to find out the movements and load. Okay, if this problem is asked, we have to use this equation to find out the movement and load. Ultimate movement and ultimate load. This is for polygonal shape. So next is problem statement is, fixed a circular slab isotropically reinforced and subjected to uniformly distributed load over entire surface. Okay. So by seeing the formulas or equations used to find out the movement and load, it is similar to the polygon. Same equation we have to use to find out the movements and load. Okay. So here you can see this is the radius R. And this is the fixed support. Due to fixed support, these are the yield lines created, and infinity yield lines are there, and a circular yield line, which you can, dotted line, you can see that is a negative yield line because the support is fixed. So this is for circular slab. Okay. this is about what we have seen today about the equations or how to find out the moments and load for the different shapes of slabs by using yield line theory. Okay. So for this, creating this PowerPoint presentation, the reference are RCC Designs Reinforced Concrete Structure by B.C. Pulmiya, Ashok Kumar Jain and Arun Kumar Jain, and second one is Advanced Concrete Design by S.S. Bhavikatti. Okay. Thank you.